Virtual cameras on. What's up, guys? This is Zach with PC Sports Cards. This is another lot we just bought. I'll give a minute or two for a few people to get on. Just wanted to go over the lot we bought. Paid $580 for this. Waiting to see how you think we did. And I'm going to go through it in a little bit. I saw someone posted. I saw like a video. Both probably 2 weeks ago. I just haven't had a chance to really go through it yet. It came in a week later. So, yeah, I'm going to start going through the cards now. I don't know who Chase Jordan is. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to take stacks. This is the Anthony Rizzo stack. And go through them that way. Just pick them up off the floor. Be easier than doing it in this space. So these are all Rizzo cards. So again, 580. Not sure who decided to top load these and put them in sleeves. These are cards that generally, I mean, these are not even Schwarber rookies. There's some rookies. Maybe, I think this is a rookie. 2015, so it's a like XRC Platinum. I don't think any of the Schwarber stuff's worth grading, but we might just list those all as a lot. First Chrome Refractors, maybe that's cool. X-Fractor, just a cool-looking card. The Meme Factory. What's up, Joel? I am spoiling you guys. I wasn't aware of any of these Schwarber cards when I bought this lot, so.
I promise it's better than that. I promise. I'll take out the, I paid $580 for everything. Hold on one sec to the person. If you go to the website, I'll type it out there. One sec, guys. This is for the Meme Factory. PCSportsCards.com/grading. The mailing address will be there. It's 1983 Marcus Ave, Suite 102, New Hyde Park, NY 11042. Attention grading. So it's right here for the address, but you can also get it on the website. All right, let's go to. Hopefully, it gets better. I'm hoping. Aaron Judge cards. It says Chase Gordon. I have no idea who that is.
Never heard of Chase Jordan. Sorry. All right, so these are all Judge stuff. I'm in focus. He is a Philly, but those aren't good ones. So Judge first paper. So again, I paid $580 for all this. These is PSA 10s are still over $100. So those are pretty good. These are like, I think, $20. It should be where I put it, but yeah, these are all Judge second year, third year. So some Judge rookies. These are $100 as PSA 10s. I'm guessing a lot of these aren't PSA 10s, but it seemed like a no-brainer to me just on the Judges alone. So again, I paid $580 for this whole two row. I get to the Schwarber. The Schwarbers and Rizzos are just commons. It's not their bad cards. Like he's a bad player. I don't understand why they were sleeved. All right, this is the Pujols section. 2002, so the second year, second year. I get if these are gradable, those are good PSA 10s. I don't think they will be. There's a Judge, misplaced Judge, duel with Clarkin. So if you see some base Pujols lots, that numbered? No. You know, I think that's the cherry tree right there. Pujols. Yeah, to me, Schwarber less so because he's been on so many different teams. But, yeah, Baez because of how much of a stud he was in the Cubs. Here's the next pile. These ones are all Ohtanis apparently. So I think I did all right. $580 for all this because, I mean, even though these are optic, I feel like these got to be at least $50 as PSA 10 rookies. Platinum rookie. And you can grade, obviously, anything Ohtani. Let me know if I'm going too fast through the cards. I can go slower, but those are all Ohtanis. I mean, these cards aren't like necessarily great, but good names. All Tatises. Base stuff. Michael Harris. I guess this guy bought a lot of retail. A Heritage 2022 Tony Gwynn throwback or something. I don't know what that is. I'll have to look it up. Bobby Witt, Topps Holiday Rookies. This one doesn't have a label, so I'm just guessing. Okay, I guess he's not really playing up to the hype. I'm Blaze Jordan, but yeah, pro debut. Blaze Jordan auto, unlicensed stuff. Those are probably $5-$10 each. So, yeah, I think I'm doing pretty well. I'm still good. I just feel like the judges alone, I'm good as long as some are gradable. Some Mookies, a couple firsts. I feel like this was a really good deal at 580. Yeah. I mean, the judge, five of those are worth $500 alone if they're 10s. Donruss rookies, which for Mookie, pretty decent. He doesn't have a ton of rookies. And he stopped signing, so.
This one's the J-Rod pile. So we got a bunch of J-Rods, too.
Topps Update rookie. Topps Holiday. I guess it's not a rookie, the 2022 Bowman Chrome. I guess the first release they didn't, but he made the team at the gate. Prism rookie, another holiday rookie, leaf, some inserts, some first year draft paper. A Topps Holiday rookie relic is probably decent. First paper, $50 piece of 10. The Meme Factory. What was the name on the email? Bowman Chrome rookie J-Rod. Or which email did you send it to? Juan DeFranco on fire. Bunch of Franco rookies. And I guess Kyle Lewis is mixed in with Franco, but, you know, we forgive.
So I'm pretty happy
with the $580 I spent right now. So I'll even take Kyle Lewis. Soto. You know, talking about his numbers lately, I don't think any of these are cards we're going to grade anytime soon. But. Especially because they're all base, not even like refractors. Acuna. Nothing crazy. First year draft paper. Trout. I don't know what those cards are. That's a fake reprint. Are these the actuals? Oh, these are like his minor league rookies. Those are decent. If they're real, they might be reprints. Yeah, Brown and Proper, but they have in the draft, there's paper too.
Yeah, the Julios look decent. There's some decent Julios there.
All right, and not to mention, this is also in the same lot. There are also some nice autos. Like, there's Vlad. I'm not sure who this is, but I'll look him up. I'm not sure who this is. Actually, we've sold a lot of this guy. I don't think he sells super well. Yeah. Thanks, Tyre. I don't think that's what I meant to say, but thank you. You got some relics. Yeah, I got you. He had to debut in 21 to be on the first rookie in the first release. They would put it in the later, in like the actual Bowman Chrome release versus the Bowman proper first release. Some relics. Carlos Rodon, auto number 250. Dixon Machado, he sold for a minute. He doesn't sell anymore because he's not really the bigs. Number 25. Allen Webster, scrub. Lou Thorpe, 2014, Bowman Chrome. Kurt Casale, 2015, Bowman Draft. Perez, Greg Allen, Tyler Gilbert. Rookies. Gavin Sheets, CJ Abrams. So this just rookies. I grade those a lot, the silver pack ones. I just make sure that they're clean on the centering. Benintendi rookie auto card that used to be big. Bonds relic. Tex. There's like four Tex autos. This was a rookie. It's numbered to 350. Sorry for that noise.
I think they you get a lot of nines on those, the silver packs. So just be on the lookout.
You don't really want him as nines. Correa, Trey Turner base. I don't know who this is, but it's a red refractor. Number five, Corbin Burns, rookie numbered. Torque. Is this a variation? Because I have his regular card, and it doesn't look – it looks like this one. So this might be a decent O'Neal Cruz. Yeah, that's what I was saying, Ty. But you're right, though, because he didn't debut in 21, and 21 would be Bowman first release. I didn't think about that. These are all the whatever. This guy is hitting pretty decent. Born in Germany. Metallic. I don't know who Armando Cruz is. Gavin Sheets is not Sheet. I'll tell you that much. All right. Sorry about the arm. Sorry, guys. Let's get you back on. There we are. All right. I'm losing space. Shane Baz. I don't. Riley Adams, rookie. Drew Gilbert. I think he was first round pick, right? 20th overall, yeah. Some Drew Gilberts. Jeremy Pena rookies. 1, 2, 3, 4. Might not be worth grading those right now. He's not selling too hot. I know Wilman Diaz, and I know these guys are all decent. I'm assuming this guy bought in Dodgers in a break. Sean McClain. John McClain. Jay Allen. Tyler Black. So, yeah, I mean, I paid $580 for this. We're hitting the dead part of the lot, but maybe we'll find a Zach Gallen rookie. He's a stud. Melendez. Lou Bob. Buxton. Adley. Leaf. Bobby Witt, Carlson, Tatis, Dominguez, J-Rod. These will probably sell a lot. Acuna, Mauricio, what year is all this? 2020. Franco. There's the Chris Bryant stuff. Talk about Cubs. Mr. Cub himself. Cards that used to be worth more. Yeah, like he's got these base cards, like double sleeved, crazy. Rizzo. Maybe I do a Rizzo, Bryant, Schwarber, Cubs lot, you know? And there's Baez, Soler, Baez. It's a photo variation. It might be a photo variation. Baez, rookie, Baez. Yeah, if you think back, man, that's a guy who's really like kind of falling off as far as baseball goes. That's the end of the lot. Javi Baez, a couple years ago when he was playing Super Gold Glove stores. I like plat. What's the top one? I think they have one called either Platinum Glove or Diamond. Like he was playing the best defense in the league at shortstop, and he could do it at second, third. Amazing defender, was hitting 40 bombs, and he's just like, I mean, he's just an irrelevant player at this point. I mean, let's see. Hold on. Look up his numbers. Like they're atrocious. So he's hitting 196 this year. Jesus Christ. I think he was MVP runner-up, right? Yep, MVP runner-up in 2018. 34 homers, 4 doubles, 111 RBIs, 290. And he was Gold Glove caliber defender. 2021, he hit 31 home runs, 184 Ks, Jesus Christ, between two teams. But 2020, okay, that doesn't count. Then last year, 17 homers, 238. 670 OPS, like brutal, man. That guy fell off a cliff. Hopefully he has a good year this year. Yeah, he started falling. When he was on the Mets 2 years ago, he kind of sucked too, though. So, yep, maybe that's what it is. He got paid. But it was really like his defense. It was like must-see TV every night. So, anyway, paid $580 for all this. Looking at it, I feel like just singles. Forget all like the crappy quarter cards that you had to put in a lot, but like the first rookies, the rookies and stuff, I feel like there's at least 800 to 1,000 here before grading. So I'm pretty happy with how I did. You got 3 Tex autos.
Go Yanks.
Tex autos were big. I remember he was one of the bigger guys you could have. Pena, I'm assuming these aren't worth much grading, to be honest. His stuff's kind of going down, even though he's playing really well. But I like his Topps Chrome Update rookie PSA 10s are $30, it looks like, and we got a couple sitting, and those are just better cards, more desirable than a Bowman Chrome and the Bowman Chrome rookies of guys that aren't first. Find those aren't super desirable. Corbin Burns is dope. Alex DeJesus got some pop. Yeah, they definitely got off him at the right time. I don't know if they got lucky because they knew the player. Yeah, he should be a stud, though. Yeah. These are kind of the bad autos. Pete Alonso. I mean, some of these relics will get $5 each, too. Anyway. All right, guys. That's all I got for you. Thanks for coming on. And as always, thanks for the back and forth. Makes it a lot more fun to do these type of things. Makes me want to do it. I'm going to try to get on the videos a little bit more. I know Josh generally does them on YouTube. I'm trying to get a little more content up here too for us. Go through some stuff. And just apologies always ahead of time for the camera work. I'm not necessarily the best with that technology. Thanks for coming on. Joel, I'm probably going to grade the red if the guy doesn't suck. I got to look up if he sucks or not. I mean, if it's gradable, I'm going to grade it. Even if the guy sucks. It's a first. It's not even like a non-first. I'm definitely grading the red. Any other ones? I mean, like the judges here. I'll go, for example. Like, here's all the judges I'd grade. 1, 2, 3. All these. Not that one. 1, 2, 3, 4. These. Not the paper. That paper. The blacks. Like, this many cards alone a judge, I'm going to have to review. Sorry. Make it more clear. And then there was all the J-Rods. Like, the... I don't think the paper debuts, but let's go to J-Rod now. Sorry. 1, 2, 3, 4. Maybe the Prism, actually. 5. Not doing leaf crap. I actually might consider these because same as the first year. That card's kind of cool. It's a refractor. So then J-Rod, I'm looking over... this many cards for grading. That's another 20. The Mookies, all of these. I don't know about the Donruss. I got to check what they sell for. So, I mean, there's probably 100 cards to grade here, which obviously then would put my money in the lot from 5A to 1,900 more. But obviously the value would also go up a ton. I don't know why those ones were on the side. Michael Harris. Not going to grade any of that stuff. So, yeah, this will keep me busy for a couple hours going through all of it, and then we're listing it. Yeah, then, I mean, look at Otani. I don't know what year that is, but. Cherry tree for short. And he's in, like, I'm going to review all those Otanis, too. So, yeah. And maybe some of those pool holes. Guys, thanks again. I'm not trying to drag you on here too much longer. Excited for this live.